Okay, so the NBA season has just started and it's relatively early. And I'm personally, I think that this season is a little bit below average. It's one of the worst seasons I think we've had in a while so far, and I know it's still early. So today I have a few reasons on why I think that this NBA season is a little bit below average. I mean, at the end of the day, it's basketball and it's still good, but it's just a below average season compared to like last year, 2018, 19, and years up before that. But yeah, I have four main reasons, and this is going to be kind of like a rant, so it's going to be all one take. Unless like I accidentally let go of the voiceover thing, but it's gonna be all one take. So if I like mess up on some parts, just know it's one take. So let's get right into it. Okay, the first thing I'm talking about are the rookies. So the rookies heading into the 2021 NBA draft, the main four were Cade Cunningham, Jalen Green, Evan Mobley, and Jalen Suggs. And now that we've all seen them go to their respective teams, a lot of them have been disappointing. First guy I want to look at is Cade Cunningham. I was super high on him, but he's having a pretty bad year so far. In 7 games played, averaging 12 points, 3 assists, and 5 rebounds, shooting 32% and 23% from 3, which is terrible. Honestly, Cade Cunningham, he was the consensus number one overall pick, and this year he's not even playing like a top 5 rookie. Next up is Jalen Green, who is playing a little bit better, 14 points, about 3 assists and 3.5 rebounds. Again, 36% from the field and 29% from 3. Not very good, and the Rockets are terrible this year, so that's another disappointing player. And the next disappointing guy I want to talk about is Jalen Suggs. The Magic, once again, are terrible. All three of these teams are terrible. 11 points a game, 3 assists, 3 rebounds, 31% from the field and 20% from the 3-point line. So those three rookies, three of the four rookies are playing, the big four rookies we called it before the draft, are playing terrible. Instead, there are new rookies that are playing good. First off, Evan Mobley, he's like the only rookie there that's playing good. 16 points, 8 rebounds, 2 assists, a block and a half, a steal, 50% from the field, and he even hit a 3. Scotty Barnes, the number 4 overall pick, went over Suggs. A lot of people thought that was a bad pick, me being one of them. 16 points, 8 rebounds, 3 assists, 50% from the field. And the third guy I want to talk about is Chris Duarte, who, just like Jalen Suggs, is averaging, or Jalen Green, is averaging 14 points, 2 rebounds, 4 assists, but he's shooting a lot better, 43% from the field and 40% from 3. So those are the top 3 rookies. Right now, the order is Mobley, Barnes, Duarte. But yeah, overall the rookies, a lot of them have been playing very like it's still really early, and I shouldn't be judging them off of this. I'm not saying that they're gonna be bad. I just think that they've been disappointing this year, which is kind of a bummer, honestly. And the next thing I'm talking about now are the standings. So the standings, this is one that is like, it doesn't really make it a bad season. To me, it does, but maybe for you or someone else, it doesn't. So we have a lot of surprising teams and we have a lot of disappointing teams like we do every year. First things I want to talk about, obviously, are the Lakers and the Nets. Two teams that were look like guaranteed going to the finals. Nets, they're doing pretty good, 9-4 at the moment. But the Lakers, 7-6, not playing good. I just watched their game against the Spurs and they played okay. They did win, so I guess now they're 8-6. But yeah, the Westbrook thing, that's a huge problem. Westbrook's been really disappointing this year. And honestly, they don't look like a team that can make the finals. I know it's not just the record, but yeah. And as for other teams, the Golden State Warriors are dominating this year, 11-1 without Klay Thompson. Honestly, I can make another whole video about how Steph Curry's the MVP this year and Gary Payton is amazing and all these players. But yeah, they've been playing amazing this year. They look unstoppable. One loss was to Memphis, I believe. The Washington Wizards are actually 9-3, which is really is shocking me this year. I thought they would be like the 14th seed, but they're playing pretty good. And the Phoenix Suns are 8-3. Chicago Bulls are 8-4. And the last team I want to talk about that's surprising are the Cleveland Cavaliers, 9-5. I did not expect this, but Evan Mobley has just been so impactful. Having one of like the best impact as a rookie we've seen in a while. Like, no rookie has given a team this much impact, but Cleveland starts off good every year. Yeah. And another two teams I want to talk about are Milwaukee, the Milwaukee Bucks, the defending champions, 6-7, not very good this year, especially because they're the champs. And the Atlanta Hawks, 4-9, which is actually one of the worst in the league. So the Atlanta Hawks have been disappointing. So yeah, overall, the surprising teams don't bother me. It's just the disappointing teams. I mean, the Lakers, they were the title favorites, I think, this year. the Bucks, the defending champs, and the Hawks, the Eastern Conference runner-ups, all doing terrible, which just, I don't think it makes basketball fun. Okay, like, it's still okay, because now we have more competition, and it's not just super teams dominating, but I think I would like to have some teams like the Bucks and the Hawks doing a little bit better. But yeah. And the third thing I want to talk about are actual disappointing players. So, this NBA season, I'm going to get to this later, but it's just so inefficient, the whole season combined. Like, I would like to combine everyone's field goals and just see what they average as a league, because they have been very inefficient. Every single player, most players, have been very inefficient. I'm going to go over this. So, I chose three disappointing players. You can let me know in the comments who I missed. There were some more I wanted to choose, but these are just three disappointing players, I think, so far. First one is Damian Lillard, 20 points, 8 assists. For Lillard, that is awful. He's used to 25 to 30 points. But yeah, for Lillard, this is not doing too good for him. 20 points, 8 assists. And this is a perfect example of field goals. 38% from the field and 27% from three. Again, Lillard standards, that's terrible. The next guy, James Harden, another one. 20 points, 9 assists, 8 rebounds. The 8 rebounds is fine. But James Harden, the thing with him is, every year, he either scores a lot or assists a lot. Like, he gets a lot of, but he used to get a lot of buckets in Houston. Ever since training to Brooklyn, his averages went down to like 25 points a game, but he was getting like 11 or 12 assists. But now here, he is scoring less and assisting less. And overall, he is just not playing up to James Harden standards. 43% from the field, 41% from three. And the last guy, Russell Westbrook. Russell Westbrook himself has been playing pretty good. He already has 3 triple-doubles, but just he doesn't fit with the Lakers. 19 points, 9 rebounds, 8 assists. 42% from the field, or 43% from the field, and 30% from 3, 66% from the line. And yeah, Westbrook overall has also been pretty disappointing, but I'm not really here to criticize those guys. You get the point when I mean players have been disappointing this year. There's a big list, and yeah, it's another thing that's not really fun. And the last thing I want to talk about are the injuries this year. Every year there are so many injuries. We can't go a year without injuries, but that's just normal. This isn't really hating on this year because injuries happen every year. Whenever a team wins a championship, it's always like, oh, they got past this round because of this star player was injured. So this isn't really hating, but it just kind of adds on to the bad season. Some notable injuries are Kawhi Leonard, who will be out for most of the season. Jamal Murray, same thing. Klay Thompson, same thing. He might be out. He might come back Christmas. LeBron James, who's out for a little bit. Damian Lillard, Joel Embiid, Zion Williamson, and the last two notable guys, I think, like, we expect this. Ben Simmons and Kyrie Irving aren't really injured, but this whole drama, honestly, it's kind of fun at this point, seeing them like that. But yeah, so those are four reasons why I think that this NBA season is bad, quote unquote. It's not bad. Like, 2020 was a pretty bad season because of the bubble year and stuff. So it's still really early and it can get better. But my four main reasons were the underperforming rookies, because nobody's bad this year. Like, at the end of the day, like, you're in the NBA, that's good. Underperforming rookies, surprising and disappointing teams, disappointing players, and injuries. These can all play a part into why the season is below average, because like I said, basketball is basketball. Basketball is always amazing to watch. But yeah, that's gonna wrap up this video, guys. I really hope you enjoyed. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.